chaired by the Mbarara South Division MP Mwene Mpaka, the Parliamentary Committee on Trade and Tourism has intensified the crackdown on unsafe and substandard products on the market. In a committee meeting today, the Acting Secretary of the National Drug Authority, David Nahamia, addressed the committee on their new findings, indicating that some popular energy drinks contain excessive caffeine content of 39 mils per 100 mils against the approved standard of 32 mils per 100 mils, which is harmful to the consumers.
When we are doing analysis, we do it batch by batch. That is the batch we picked. So when we are also recording, we record the batch. Maybe that does not necessarily mean that maybe all the batches are contaminated, because we analyze batch per batch. So the batch we picked is the one which had that issue.
NDS says tests are ongoing for many other energy drinks to establish their conformity to standards, but warned that provisional results indicate more rag behind approved standards.
I need you to tell us all the products that have caffeine that is above the standard.
Honorable members, we have just picked this because in the list which you had been given, we're not given this thing, but we have just picked and we're analyzing. But the labor claim is okay. The labor claim is they are claiming, how much is it? 32, which is within the standard. That's the labor claim. But the analysis is going on because we have just picked it.
However, the Committee of Trade and Tourism has given energy drink manufacturers a second chance before any action is taken and sent NDS samples to an independent laboratory to review the findings.
Since we have got results from NDA only, we need to give our colleagues from Rockboom a fair hearing. So we request your samples be taken to an independent lab. Legally, even UNBS would have to verify the results got from NDA.
The MPs have established that there are no clear standards on the fast-growing energy drink known as kombucha, which is widely being consumed by the Ugandans. This drink is said to have originated from Latin America, but UNBS is yet to set its standards.
We've not seen any of the kombucha drinks that have exceeded the 32 milligrams. And whereas we requested, though late, for other competing drinks to be verified by NDA in regard to the caffeine. And whereas NBA has given us a number of results, I suppose that there is still some controversy between NDA and UNBS.
A recent standard 2019, locally made. Now, the parameters that were discussed at that time did not include caffeine, because the products they are using to make kombucha, you see, caffeine is not allowed to be added. It is from the natural product. And as we mentioned last time, the ingredients that they use, coffee, tea or malt, sugar, yeast, and the SCOBY, as I mentioned, the SCOBY and the potable water that they used to mix. So coffee and tea have natural amounts of caffeine within them.
For us as a committee, we look at the caffeine. We don't care if you got it naturally. If it is natural, really, you must have a way of regulating it. If a young kid takes this drink, because you are saying it was put in that drink naturally, and gets hypertension, high blood pressure, and dies, you will not say, okay, it was not because it got naturally from the tea. No, caffeine is caffeine.
NDA has also reported that many herbal drinks are contaminated with Viagra to stimulate potence, whereas many energy drinks don't warn consumers on caffeine content in their products.
We are looking for adulterants, which are drugs, because in our experience, most of these herbalists have been contaminating the herbal drugs with some, for example, Viagra. We are also trying to look for Viagra. Viagra, in the scientific name, is sildenafil. There's another generic one called...
Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.